Hello everyone, I am Dean. I am a Senior Analytics Specialist Solution Architect focusing on big data services like AWS Glue. Joining me today is Arun. He is also an Analytics Specialist Solution Architect. In this session, we are going to talk about Glue Blueprints and how it supports creating and sharing Glue workflow for similar use cases within your organization. Data engineers spend significant effort and time building data integration pipeline, performing tasks like extracting, cleaning, and loading data. Every time they onboard a new source, they need to rinse and repeat the whole process from the scratch. Similar to building data integration pipeline, there are requests to build reusable functionalities like data partitioning, file format conversion, etc. from various teams. Every time a request from a new team comes, data engineer will spend cycles duplicating and retesting already built functionality for that team. This approach is slow, expensive, and ineffective. AWS Glue Blueprint addresses this problem by offering framework for you to build and share reusable Glue workflows. Now let's take a closer look at the process of building Glue Blueprints. AWS Glue Blueprint provides organizations a mechanism to develop, share, and reuse complex ETL workflow. They assist ETL developers to generate and publish templates of commonly asked ETL workflow that analysts or other non-developers can consume and execute jobs without having to write code. You can see Glue Blueprint lifecycle in this slide with series of steps. Step 1, data engineer identifies data ingestion pattern and creates blueprints. A blueprint in AWS Glue is a zip archive that consists of a blueprint configuration file, a layout generator script, and optional ETL scripts and supporting file. Step 2, data engineers shares this blueprint via source control tool or S3. Step 3, non-developers persona can easily register and use this blueprint using a user interface where they provide input as parameters. Finally, blueprint uses these parameters to generate AWS Glue workflow, and users can simply execute this workflow to ingest and transform data. Now that you know what is Glue Blueprint, let's look at the scenario and data set for this demo. One of the common tasks in building data lake is to convert raw file to columnar file format like Apache Parquet before consumption. You may already know that Parquet file format provides multiple times better performance and lower cost compared to row-based files like CSV or JSON for analytical workloads. One of the main challenges is that source data are being generated in various file format, and because of that, you need to develop and test and deploy pipeline for each file format. You can significantly reduce the effort for development and testing by using Glue Blueprints. We are going to demonstrate the same using Amazon product data, which is in CSV file format, and reviews data, which is in JSON file format. We will be converting them to Parquet using Glue Blueprints. If you had to do this without Glue Blueprints, you would have to manually create multiple jobs and workflow for each file format. But Glue Blueprint simplifies this process. We will reuse the same blueprint to convert both JSON and CSV files to Parquet file format. The same blueprint can be used in future to ingest other file format. Now, I'll hand over to Arun to provide the demo of this scenario.
Hello everyone. For the purpose of this demo, we will be using a Glue Blueprint that performs data format conversion. This blueprint can convert files in any format, that is, format supported by the Glue crawler such as CSVs or JSONs, into a more data lake optimized format, Apache Parquet. This blueprint and many more are available on our public GitHub page. At a later part in this demo, we will take a deeper look at the contents of a blueprint. Until then, as Dean already mentioned, it is a collection of files under a zip archive that helps generate repeatable workflows. We have our conversion blueprint already uploaded to an S3 location in our demo account. Before we head over to the AWS Glue console, let us explore our dataset. For this demo, we will be using the publicly available Amazon Reviews dataset for magazines. The dataset consists of two types of files, a CSV metadata file with Amazon standard identification number that correlates this dataset with reviews data, which is in JSON format. Let us use Glue Blueprint to transform both of these datasets into a more data lake optimized format, Apache Parquet. We start by logging into the Glue console. On the left-hand side of the console, there is a link Blueprints, which we will be using to create them. We click on Add Blueprints, which exposes a standard blueprint creation form. Let us create our data format conversion blueprint, starting with an appropriate name. The blueprint names can contain alphabets A to Z or numbers 0 to 9. Underscore and hyphen are the only special characters allowed. Point the blueprint to our zip file, which has already been uploaded to an S3 location. You can add an optional description and then click the Add Blueprint button. The blueprint will be created. You can wait until the status turns to active. Now that our blueprint has been created and active, our next step is to create workflows. Follow the UI options to create our first workflow, which will convert the CSV reviews metadata to Parquet. We enter the workflow name, which in our case is CSV to Parquet. Next, we enter a pre-created IAM role. This is the role that will be attached to our Glue ETL jobs and crawlers, and it should have privileges to create databases, access S3 files, etc. We now point the input to the S3 location where our CSV data is located. Next, we enter a database and table name in which the converted data will be stored. In case the DB or table doesn't exist, it will be created. We also mention a destination location to store the converted Parquet files. The blueprint allows you to schedule the workflow using the frequency fields. However, for the purpose of this demo, we will skip this optional section and run the workflow on demand. Additionally, you can configure the number of Glue workers for your workflow, which again we will leave it for the defaults. Finally, we provide a pre-existing IAM role that Glue can assume, and the role should have permissions to create workflow and AWS resources associated to it. We click on the Submit button to initiate the workflow creation process. We will now check on the status of our workflow. We see it has changed from running to succeeded. We will follow the same set of instructions to create our next workflow, which will convert the JSON reviews dataset to Parquet. When you compare this step to the previous, what changes are the name of the workflow, the location of the input and output, and also the destination table name. Using the same blueprint, we were able to create two workflows working on two different data formats. Let us trigger them both and wait for it to complete. Now that both the workflows have successfully executed, let us take a look at the results. We see that the S3 output location has been populated with the Parquet equivalent of the source files. Additionally, the Glue catalog holds entries to both the source and converted files, making it easier for the files to be consumed in a tabular manner by other analytics services such as Athena or EMR. Before we conclude, let us take a deeper look at the contents of a blueprint. And for this, let us extract our archive file. As you can see, this particular archive contains four files, of which we will take a closer look. The first file, named blueprint.cfg, is a mandatory file that defines the entry point into the blueprint. It contains the parameters that form the user input, their data types, and associated properties. It is this file that drives the workflow configuration form that we used earlier to create our workflows. The configuration file also contains a pointer to the layout descriptor. The layout.py, which is the layout descriptor file, is yet another mandatory file in the blueprint archive. This is a Python file that contains a function that defines the glue workflow. It parses the form field we entered earlier. For example, you can see the workflow name being extracted out to a variable in this step. The code creates any necessary databases and tables. Similarly, it creates the crawler and glue job. Scheduling information, if any, is parsed and used. Finally, the workflow is created. In addition to the configuration file and layout descriptor, the blueprint archive can have multiple glue job scripts, such as conversion.py in our example. It may also contain a README and other supporting files. If we take a step back and inspect one of our workflows, we see that it consists of a trigger, a crawler, and an ETL job. You can navigate to the respective sections of the Glue console to individually inspect them. The job section, for example, has an auto-generated PySpark code responsible for the data transformation. This is created from the script file that we had in our zip archive. To summarize, we were able to use Glue blueprints to create and share AWS Glue workflows. Rather than creating a separate workflow for each similar use case, the logic was abstracted into a single repeatable Glue blueprint. We hope this session helped you familiarize the concept of Glue blueprints. Please feel free to gather more information from our documents using the links on screen. Thank you for watching.